Welcome to Awesome Code. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. In this video, we will learn how to use a lambda expression in C++. Lambda expression are anonymous function objects. They allow us to write a shortcode snippet to be used as a standard library function predicate. Lambda have a capture list marked by square brackets where we can capture local variable by reference or copy. Parameter list with optional parameters marked with round brackets and a lambda body mark with a curly brace. Let's see how to use it in our C++. So first I'm going to include IO screen and include vector and include algorithm. We are going to use vector and count if function to count the number of even vector elements. Here we go, include IO screen, include vector, include algorithm. And now our main function. So I will add a line for using namespace std. And now I will have a vector with some int values. I will let it be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then I will have an auto type counter where we are going to count the number of even elements in our vector. So this will be using count a function. And then begin and pass in our vector, and the end and pass in our vector to end function. And now I'm going to use a lambda expression. First we are going to use a square brackets, then type it will be of int I, and then we are going to return I mod by 2 equals 0. And then going to print the count of vector elements. Here we are going to pass in our counter and then end of line, correct? And just going to save it. So we are going to go through all the elements of our vector from begin to end, and then we are going to check for even numbers in our lambda expression, and then this count if function will count the number of even for us. So at the end we are going to print the count of vector elements. Let's run our program and check the results. And over here we can see the count of vector elements is equal to 5. there are five. Over here, I'm going to add vector of e, count of even vector elements. So these are, there are five even elements in our vector. To keep on learning, please subscribe to my YouTube channel, Awesome Code. Keep supporting me, and thank you for